Welcome back, everybody. IGN Live from Gamescom 2016. I'm Damon Hatfield. It's time to take a look and talk about Mafia 3. Andy Wilson is executive producer, and Bill Harms is the lead writer on the game. Gentlemen, welcome to the show.
Thanks for having us.
You guys have brought a new trailer to Gamescom. So this is correct?
That is correct.
Nailed it. So we're going to watch the trailer first, and then we'll come back and we'll sort of rerun the trailer, and you guys will be able to commentate on it a little bit. But first, let's just watch the trailer. Let's roll that now.
Now, when I was a little boy,
at the age of five, back up to Lone Dark.
I had something in my mind. Keeps a lot of folks alive. My man, I'm 21.
Police continue to search the French ward for at least four men believed to be involved in the robbing of the Federal Reserve.
We can have a lot of fun.
There's gonna be a lot of heat coming down off of what we've done tonight.
You need to relax, Sal.
Hey, we're gonna pull this off.
Look like you could use a drink. Wanna get changed? We need to get ourselves over to Sammy's, collect our cut of that money. And George, there's one more thing we need to do.
This isn't just money. It's freedom.
I need you with me on this.
I'm with you, Pop.
You mind pouring one more, though? Couldn't pull it off without you, Sammy.
Okay, so set this up for us. Mafia 3, we know it takes place 1968 in New Bordeaux, a fictionalized version of New Orleans.
That's correct.
There's a heist going on. What do we need to know about this?
So one of the kind of pertinent narrative points is that when Lincoln Clay returns from Vietnam, Sammy Robinson, his kind of adopted father, is in trouble with Sal Marcano. And so this is part of them trying to get out from underneath Sal and rectify things.
In trouble with the Italian mob?
Exactly.
Okay. Yeah, so feel free to just say stop and run that back if you want to point
to anything. I'm just going to run it up a little bit, then I'll...
Sure.
So right here, so I'm not going to go too much into the story details, what's going on.
Sure.
But obviously we have Lincoln Clay in the background there, the main character. Mm-hmm. And then Georgie, he's the son of Sal Marcano, who's the don of the city.
Okay.
So the cool thing about to me about this is that it really shows the power of Sal and the Italian mafia. Mm-hmm. Again, not to spoil anything, but you have two guys who show up to a Federal Reserve in Federal Reserve uniforms. Mm-hmm. They're driving a Federal Reserve truck. They literally have the combination to the vault. Mm-hmm. So to me, that really reinforces the power of the Italian mafia in New Bordeaux.
Sure. And so this must be taking place either very early in the game or before the events of the game unfold. Is that true?
Yeah, so this is the start of the game.
Gotcha. Breaking into the vault.
Yep, so here they go in. And then if you pause right here. So this is the interesting thing about this trailer is we actually went back and shot. I wrote a script and we wrote and mocapped a custom scene that doesn't appear in the game. It only appears here.
I see.
And so what this is Sal, that's Sal Marcano right there. And here in a second, we'll see Olivia. She's the person who tells Sal to relax.
Okay.
She's one of his capos. And so what we're seeing is the heist from Sal's point of view. And what they're doing is they're waiting for news of whether or not it was successful.
Okay.
So that's
Olivia right
this
there.
This is interesting, actually, because it's the first time we've kind of shown the extended Marcano family as well.
Yeah.
So they're all going to play a part. And a lot of the sort of bigger story-based missions are where you meet the Marcanos, the extended family, and you get to kind of know them a little bit better.
I see. in the actual game? Is that heist something you get to play through?
Yeah. Okay. If we pause it right here. So, yeah, so you play the heist is playable. Okay. It's Lincoln and Georgie. They're the ones actively involved, like basically entering the vault. Mm-hmm. You see that right here on the very right there with the backpack and the hat, that's Ellis. That's Sammy Robinson's biological son. He's basically Lincoln's kind of pseudo-adopted brother.
Okay.
On the left in the awesome racing jacket, mm-hmm. that's Danny Burke. He's the son of Thomas Burke, who becomes one of the underbosses later in the game. He's the head of the Irish mob.
Okay.
And obviously the setting here is Mardi Gras. So, you know, even though it's fictionalized New Orleans,
sure.
you think of New Orleans, you think Mardi Gras. So sure. We knew that we wanted to have a big important moment in the game set during the Mardi Gras festivities.
Yeah.
I think the other thing here is that you start the game with this crew. You get to know all of these guys. So when we come to sort of the inciting incident for the wider story, which you'll see at the end of the trailer, you've already got to know some of these characters. So, you know, obviously there are people who become your enemies, or one in particular here further into the game, but that's not how the game actually starts.
I see.
There's my boy.
And then we'll pause here. So this is the moment after Lincoln fires the gun in the air. Mm-hmm. They basically split up, and this is Georgie returning to Sal. Mm-hmm. So Lincoln, Danny, and Ellis return to Sammy's, mm-hmm. while Georgie goes back home to Sal.
Right.
My boy, look like you could use a drink.
Want to get changed? We need to get ourselves over to Sammy's, collect our cut of that money. And Georgie, there's one more thing we need to do.
Stop it right there. So to Andy's point, we spent a lot of time, narrative-wise, it was very important to us that the player love these characters, mm-hmm. specifically like Ellis, Sammy, and Danny, so that when the betrayal happens and they're taken away, we want the player to miss them just as much as Lincoln does. But we also put a lot of effort into Georgie. He's Lincoln's friend throughout all this. You know, he's one of the guys. And this is part of the custom, you know, aspect of the trailer that we made just for this. This is the moment where Georgie realizes what Sal's real plan is going to do, mm-hmm. what his real plan is, and what they're about to do, which is go to the bar and kill everybody.
And is he a willing participant in the betrayal?
We'll see that at the very end.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
You also, actually, if you stop it for one more second, it sort of showcases Marcano's character a little bit as well, because he's not a sort of sneering villain.
Yeah.
He's actually a charmer, you know, like even, you know, myself having obviously played the game through, you do come to sort of like him in this weird kind of way. And it also shows the power that he's got over his own family and his son, how he can convince him, you know, to turn against his friend in this way.
There's one more thing we need to do.
Hour's time.
This isn't just money. It's freedom.
I need you with me on this.
So actually, stop it here for one second. We talked about Mardi Gras a little bit, but it's just one piece of what feeds into the sort of sense of time and place in the city. And we're really trying to capture 1968, mm-hmm. our variant of New Orleans, and get that all of that flavor and texture to the city. So this is one aspect of it, but we've kind of layered lots of subtlety throughout the entire game. So the city really does feel like this living, breathing thing, and you're kind of transported back to that time period.
Sure.
I'm with you, Pop.
He's gonna go along.
So we pause right there. So yeah, so that's the moment.
Yeah.
And the notion of family is a very important theme throughout the game. I mean, obviously we have Lincoln and his kind of adopted family, but also with the Marcanos. You know, his capos are his brothers and his sister-in-law, who you saw earlier. Georgie is his son. So it's very much family and loyalty, and it's a big theme that runs throughout the game.
And is Lincoln driving the boat here?
He is.
Okay.
So this is also part of the heist.
Yeah, this is like the escape.
Not to get into too much, but things don't go quite as planned.
Yeah, well, sure.
So this is how they escape.
Heists rarely do.
You might pour on one more though. Couldn't pull it off without you, Sammy.
So he actually goes to visit them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if you pause it. Yeah. Yeah, and it's actually a big moment.
Yeah.
They're not really expecting Sal.
Sure.
They thought maybe Georgie would just come get the money. Mm-hmm. But when Sal walks in, there's actually a moment where Sammy gives Sal look, like he knows
that
this is unexpected and probably not a good thing.
Yeah. It is a really great moment, actually, because you feel that menace as he walks in, and you can kind of, just from facial expressions, which the technology that we've got now, obviously, to just get an emotion across in a facial expression without necessarily using a line, it really comes across in this scene. Jeremy.
Cool. So that's sort of a look at the like instigating moments, early moments of the game of Mafia 3. I think we have some other footage we're going to pull up here. But tell me a little bit about this. This is the third Mafia game, but you're exploring a different Mafia in this game. Was it because you wanted to explore a different area of organized crime, a different type of organized crime?
So you know, one of the obviously, you know, it's Mafia, it's organized crime, but one of the things we really wanted to do in Mafia 3 is kind of reclaim what Mafia means and also expand it. Mm-hmm. So with the time and place that we're setting the game, you know, 1968 in our version of New Orleans, it kind of heralds the beginning of the end of the golden age for the classic Italian Mafia. Mm. Because, you know, previously, years earlier, you know, the federal government finally acknowledges them, they start going after them, and the mob's kind of teetering on the precipice. Mm. So fictionally within the game, Lincoln is the one who firmly pushes the Italian the Italian mafia over that precipice, and finishes them in New Bordeaux.
I see. And is it true? I think you've talked about how you've tried to build this world of New Bordeaux as an open world crime game that makes sense, meaning that even when you're not doing stuff in a story mission, it's not totally ridiculous. Yep. What you're doing as a character, is that right?
Yeah, I mean, the game is, so the city, New Bordeaux, is made of 10 districts. And within all of those districts are unique criminal rackets. So it's what we're kind of calling the criminal ecology of the city. And each of those rackets kind of ties into the wider narrative. So in order to take down the mob, Lincoln is really just picking at the seams to begin with and then working his way up. So by damaging the earning potential of a racket, that kind of brings the lieutenants and then the capos out into the open, and it gives him his shot at them.
I see. So you guys have a crime game. Plus, it also deals with very serious issues of race, and a lot of people are going to be playing this game who don't normally get to experience our society from this perspective, right? Mm-hmm. So it seems a little serious, a little heavy. Are you also building elements of humor into the game a little bit? To lighten the air a little bit?
Yeah, I would say definitely. Like, we have the character, his name's John Donovan. He's a CIA operative who Lincoln served with in Vietnam. And he's also the first person Lincoln contacts when he decides that he's going to go after Sal.
Yeah.
And Donovan is very much represents that kind of character. Mm. You know, I would say he's a joker, but he's very sarcastic.
I see.
He's also, you know, and there's a lot of humor in his sarcasm. But at the same time, he's, you know, dedicated to help his friend.
I see.
Even with Vito and Burke, two of the underbosses, Vito is obviously the protagonist from Mafia 2. There's that humor as well. Like they all have very unique personalities, and humor is a big part of both of those characters, even though there's some darkness there too. Mm.
Can you speak to what we're seeing here? It looks like some stealth gameplay sneaking into...
Yeah, I mean, the game is very much set up to play how you want to play. So if you want to go the full assault approach, you can. If you want to go in using stealth tactics, you can. If you want to use lethal or non-lethal, you can. Actually, what you're seeing here is Lincoln damaging one of the criminal rackets. So he's basically found this underground space where he can do some damage to one of the rackets. He can burn some supplies. And it also shows off the fact that there's a subterranean layer to the city as well. So we have these canals and tunnels, and obviously connected with the fan boat here, you can escape via a boat. So it's kind of, it shows a different side to the city.
I see. So I know, even though you're trying to go for a little bit more realistic interpretation of the life of crime, are you also building collectibles into the city, side stuff, extra things to do and explore?
Yeah, sure. I mean, obviously, all of the backyard stuff and all of the rackets tie up into the wider narrative. We also have collectibles in the game. We have a Playboy bat in the game as well. You actually have a magazine viewer, so as you collect these things during the course of the game, you can open them up and read them. Mm-hmm. And what's really cool, actually, is we've got some articles for each issue. And one of the things about that publication is it did have a lot of great editorial, and it had some stories that and some pieces in the 60s that really reflected what was happening in that time period. And so some of the you know, civil rights era stuff and just what was kind of going on in that part of the world. So it adds another little bit of narrative to the game as well.
What are we seeing here in this mission?
This is another criminal racket. So this is where we're trying to damage an auto theft racket. So this is a stolen car operation, and Lincoln's going in and trying to harm it. Because again, as he kind of takes out the mob's ability to earn across all of these different rackets, he's damaging Marcano's empire, but he's drawing all of these kind of these capos and lieutenants out so that he can take them down and really kind of pick apart Marcano's empire.
I see. Well, you guys, Mafia 3 is out October 7th. I'm really excited. It's a very different, it's a different type, different look at the criminal underworld, a different sort of open world crime game than we're used to playing. So really looking forward to seeing how it all turned out. Thanks for coming by the show.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Stay tuned. More to come from IGN Live at Gamescom 2016 after this.